guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that will keep my way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh Lord, some of these days I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother, howdy, when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother, hey, when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I won't. Oh, that milky white way. Some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yeah.
To behold the beauty of the Lord. to inquire in his temple. For in time of trouble, he shall hide me in his provision. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up on a rock, and now shall my head be lifted up. Enemy round about me. Therefore, would I offer up his tabernacle sacrifice of joy? I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Have mercy also upon me and answer me. When I said it, seek ye my faith. My heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord. Lead me in a plain path. Because of my enemy, deliver me not over unto the will of my enemy. For false witnesses are rising up against me, and such as Brett are cruelly. I have fainted. Unless I believe to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Thank you. the Lord will. He will take care of you. The Lord will uplift your broken heart. Give unto the Lord, O ye mighty. Give unto the Lord glory and strength. Give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Worship the Lord in beauty of holiness. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory, thunder. The Lord is upon many waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of justice. Of the Lord breaketh cedars, yea, the Lord breaketh cedars of Lebanon. He maketh them also to skip like a calf. Lebanon and sound like a young unicorn. The voice of the Lord divide the flame of fire. The voice of the Lord shaketh the wilderness. The Lord shaketh the wilderness of Kasha. The voice of the Lord maketh the hinder to cave and discover the forest and in his temple doeth everyone speak of his glory. Lord, sit up on the flood. Yea, the Lord set his kingdom forever. The Lord will give strength unto his people. The Lord will bless his people. Sing unto the Lord. O ye saint of his, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holiness.
Holy.
with the wicked and with the worker of iniquity, which speak peace to their name. Showing your love and your care for Travis, which most of us know him as Knock. The family have went to a great extent in putting a program together for us to have something to go by, to keep this order, keep it decent and in order. So I ask that let's be obedient to what the family have put together And if you have something to say, please come forward and remember. In remembrance of Knocker. I'm going to take Knocker. I'm not going to be saying Travis because I knew him better as Knocker. So if someone here that don't know him as Knocker, we all call him Knocker that know him closely. You know, been knowing him for years. The ones that been knowing him for years know him as Knocker. So when you hear me say Knocker, I'm talking about Travis Armstrong. The family have asked that if friends have something they want to reflect back on Knocker, to keep it to a minimum of 2 minutes. And if there's some more that you want the family to know, go visit them, because today is just the beginning of the grief. If you have something that you want to help them to get over this time that they're going through, especially his siblings, his grandchildren, go to them tomorrow. Go to them next week. Don't let this be the last time they see you. Because I can assure you, their grieving won't stop when we leave here. So, if you have something to say, please keep it to 2 minutes. We're down to prayer. Oh, Heavenly Father, we come this morning. Father, we come this morning knowing that you got all power in your hand. Knowing, Father, that you can mend the broken heart. You can uplift those that are down, feeling left alone right now, Father. We ask in you, Heavenly Father, where there is crying, Father, put laughter in their heart when they remember how Knocker was and what he was in their life. Because, Father, we know that this is not an end, and this is just a beginning for Knocker. So, Father, help the family this morning, Heavenly Father. Help them tomorrow. Help them as they go along the way, Father, no matter how long. We know that you know how long it's going to take, Father. Some of us will grieve for a short time, but some going to grieve for a long time, Father. But, Father, we know that you got time in your hand. And no matter how long it takes, Father, it's not long to you. So, Father, we asking you this morning, Father, just hold them up in the midnight hour, Father. We know it don't get too late for you, Father, to come to them and comfort them, Father. So we asking you this morning, Father, comfort those that are hurting this morning. Comfort them wherever and wherever they may be, Father. We know you can be there with them, Father. Father, we know you're in all places at all times. So, Father, we're asking you this morning to lead and guide us, Heavenly Father. Let us put our trust in you, not man, because we know that man can only go so far. But we know it's you and only you, Father, can go all the way to eternity with us, Father. And Father, we know with Knocker being in the prison of you right now, Father, there's no other place that he'll rather be than in your prison. Father, we're asking you this morning, help us, oh Lord, the one who are here, the one who are grieving, the one who don't quite understand why such a short time. Why he didn't have years to come. You know, Father, but help us to understand. Help us to accept your will, Father, because we know that you got a perfect will. In doing so, Father, we know you will uplift our drop-down head Mend thy broken heart. Dry up our eyes and give us joy. Oh, that wonderful joy that only you can give. And we ask this in your Son, Jesus' name. And we pray, amen, amen, and amen. Our scripture this morning will be coming out of the book of John, the 3rd chapter and the 16th verse. It says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved." It says, "He that believes on him is not condemned. But he that believeth not is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God." Thank you. And now we'll have a music by Brother Dexter.
To the family. In spite of what you're facing right now, God is still God. And we give him the praise that he deserves. He blesses us over and over again. Amen. A good God, a kind God, a loving God.
Great is our God.
Savior God, to Thee. How great Thou art. How great Thou art. Then sings my soul. How great Thou art. How great Thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to How great Thou art. How great
time together. Most of the time they would watch me. You know. But one thing that I mostly remember about Malcolm is that he had respect. His respect was a large, greater respect for me. He never said anything out of the way to me. He was always smiling. And he stayed around us. He fell in love with my mother. And a lot of times when I saw him, he would always have something to say to me. It was no matter a short conversation or a long conversation, he always respected me. He always had something to say. And I tell you today that respect takes you a long way. It doesn't matter what your lifestyle is. It doesn't matter how much money you got. It doesn't matter. Respect carries you through this life. And I'm gonna miss the time that I would be out and about, and he would come up and say, what's up, Luke? And we would begin to carry on a conversation. But I want you to know today that it was a great young man to me. never asked for anything. He always had his own. And his life is going to be missed. I know the heart is heavy today. Tears are flowing. But if you look to the hills on which coming your help, look to the hills today. And you still tell the Lord, thank you. Because this is not the last time that we all going to walk this journey, this path. We all going to leave here one day. And God has given us another chance to correct what is wrong. If you have any hatred in your heart today, any awe against somebody, let it go and give it to God. Thank you.
Is there anyone else?
Turn right onto Pecan Street South, then turn left onto Auburn Road.
Okay, thank you. Now we would have a song. Then the next, I'll be on.
Oh,
side. Don't worry, because he's there. Oh, all the time. It's gonna be some hard days along the way, but God is right there. Yes, he is. He said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. He's there. Oh, all the time. Oh, yes, he is. He's there. All the time.
He liked things done his way. And you know, we all should have some things we want done our way. But Naka was one that he believed that what he was doing was the right way, and he wanted his way if it was in his control. You know, and that's the first step in man. And being a leader, being one that is willing to stand up and believe in what you believe in and stand for it. See, Naka was his mother's baby. And that was his heart, his mother. See, Naka, he loved his siblings, he loved his family, but his mother was his heart. And you know, like with most children, the baby is always the one that seems to get the most attention, because for some reason, We learn how to be a better parent as we have children. Maybe that's the reason that baby always seem to get by with more than the rest and get the most attention. But for some reason, the mother always show that baby a little bit more than she showed the first or the milk. He was a man of integrity. Someone who had the capacity to think outside of himself. He would think of us. If he could help you, like I said earlier, he would help you. He wasn't one that, rather than helping you, he would try to put you down. He was one that, if he came to you, he came to you to help. You know, and that should be a good example for all of us. Help one another if we can help one another. It's easy to put someone down, but it's better when you can pick them up. If you're looking down, don't look down and give them a hand, because that was knock away also. He was one that took pride in seeing others doing well. You know, so many times, the human nature will give us a jealousy in our spirit. Make us want to feel like what someone else has should have been mine. And when we start feeling that way, we start finding jealousy start creeping in, and we start finding that things that we should say, I'm glad to see you have what you got, we'll try to find ways to take it away from you. But let's take some of the examples that we learned from Knock About Being Around. And I tell you, that's one that we all can put in our livelihood. Again, love one another. Love family. Knocker always did what he needed to do and tried to lead by an example. He tried to lead with fairness. But when you lead, you need to lead with an example. And let your example be a good example. Good or bad, somebody will follow you. So let's lead with good examples. Let's lead with fairness. Luck also enjoyed music. He even tried to sing sometime. Sometime I believe he thought he could sing. He loved the temptations. But I don't recall ever hearing or seeing Knocker getting on the number 100 chart. So I guess he was about like me. We tried singing, but that's about the best and far as we got was trying. But at least we tried. And see, Knocker was one that got excited. He got excited when he was gonna do something for his grandchildren. It made him feel good that he could do for his grandchildren. Let them know that he loved his children. Let them know how much he loved. He would get so excited even when he went to the grocery store just to pick up some grocery or minor things. He got excited about it. I call that love, you all. You know, so many times, some of us, when we go to the grocery store for our children, we start trying to figure out how less can I get to make them satisfied. But when you're excited about going, you'll go broke back. And Naka was one that he would spend his last on his children, his grandchildren, and his love. Naka was a sports fan. He was a lover of the Steelers. Always my main team was the Steelers also, so I guess it runs in the blood, y'all. See, Naka was a country boy, but felt like he was a city boy as well. See, Naka, to me, he was kind of like a lizard. Have you ever seen a lizard? No matter where the lizard go, he just kind of blend in. Naka was one that was able to blend in no matter where. If he was in, when he was in Atlanta, they thought he was born and raised in Atlanta. But he was out of those country woods of Lee County and over here in Chris County. Because I can tell you, when he was in Lee County, he sure enough was in the stick, y'all. But they enjoyed those sticks. And he enjoyed Cordele. No matter where he went, he remembered home. And that should be something that we should all remember what to do. See, now through his heart condition, he never complained about it. He never had a pity party about why me, why me. Even on his worst days, if you ask Naka, how are you feeling? He said, I'm feeling okay. Because he didn't want someone else worried about what he was going through. He was one that was willing to go through his ups and downs by himself and not burden anyone else. He had a big heart. It is so ironic that a person who had a big heart would succumb to his issue with his heart. That leads me to John, the 14th chapter, the 1st through the 6th verse. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God and believe in me. Said, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whether I go, you know. And the way, you know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whether thou goest. How can we know the way? Jesus said, truth, the life. No man coming to the Father but by me. And I believe on August the 7th, Knocker said, I'll fly away. Said, I'll fly away. See, there are many, there is always comfort in remembering how the one we love touched us. Touched our life in many different ways. The comfort is remembering that death is not the end. You see, death is not death if you know the Lord. It is merely a change of place, a change of state, a transfer from one realm to another. I tell you, death is not death if it killed a part of us. If it killed no part of us, except that which hinders us from the perfect life. I tell you, death is not death if it raises us in a moment from darkness to light, from weakness to strength, from sinfulness to holiness. I tell you, death is not death if it perfects our faith by making it sight and let us behold him whom he believes. Death is not death if it gives us to those we love and lost, from whom we live to whom we long to live again. Finally, death is not death. For Christ has conquered death himself. Amen. For those who trust in him. There's comfort in knowing that Nunca had established a relationship with Christ through faith. There's comfort in knowing that we can see Knock again. Our greatest comfort is found in Christ. Jesus said, come on to me, all ye that labor and are heavy burdened, and I will give you rest. Jesus has promised through the writer of Hebrew, I will never leave you nor forsake you. And it is through a relationship with Christ that Nunca was able to say, as David said, though I walk through the valley of a shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. We are not given a choice about whether to meet death or even when to meet death, only to meet death.
Come on now.
Both scriptures and experience tell us that life, no matter how long we live, is still brief. Scripture compares life to a shadow or a vapor. Life is short when compared with eternity. Yet, we have plenty of time to prepare for death. The fact is that we may not remain here. The question is, whether shall we go? See, sooner or later, it is certain that we will meet death. Fact that this is the only time and the only place that we can prepare for death. That fact should cause us to examine our life. And realize that life is a time or a choice. There are two places to spend eternity. It's heaven or hell. And equally, both are real. There are two ways to meet Christ. As a savior in this life, or as a judge in the next life. James said, and James 1 said, blessed is the man who persevere under trials, because when he has stood the test, he will receive the crown of life that God has promised to those who love him. Yes, there is sadness, sorrow, pain, but also a glimmer of hope and joy. I believe if Naka could speak to us today, he would say, don't grieve for me now. I'm free. I fought a good fight. The battle is over. The victory is won. My time seemed, many times, life seemed like a fight more than it does anything else. We get knocked down, and God help us up. We have health problems and finance problems. And then we come to a day such as this. And once again, we have to rely on God to comfort us. Too many times we think of death as coming to destroy everything for which we have lived for. But instead, we should picture death as to save those we love. Many of you may have come here today thinking that death is the end. But we should think of death as the beginning of a more abundant life. We think of losing when it should be gained. Think of pardon instead of a ride. That here on earth is the opening of the gate to eternity. So we would be much better off if we viewed death from the other side. Let's do that. Let's take a moment and look at death from the other side. See, from this side, death looked like the end. From the other side, it is the beginning. Death seems so final from this side. It appeared to be the end of life, the end of the relationship, the end of all we have worked for and all we have earned. But from the other side, death is not the end, it is the entrance. It's not a goal, it is a gateway. It's the beginning of a bright new life, eternal for the believer in Jesus Christ. See, from this side, we say Knocker is gone. From the other side, it said, here come Knocker. From this side, that is a separation. But from the other side, is it a reunion? Psalm 30 also reminds us, weeping may endure for a night, but joy come in the morning. What happened in the morning? In the morning, we will be healthy. In the morning, we will be happy. And in the morning, we will be home. That's life on the other side. And that's where North I am right now. Thank
laughter and fun. Share the happy memories we made. Do not let them wither or fade. I'll be with you in the summer sun, and when the winter chill has come, I'll be the voice that whispers in the breeze. I'm peaceful now, put your mind at ease. I've rested my eyes and gone to sleep. The memories we shared are yours to keep. Sometimes our final days may be a test, but remember me when I was at my best. Although things may not be the same, don't be afraid to use my name. Let your sorrow last for just a while. Comfort each other and try to smile. I've lived a life filled with joy and fun. Live on now, make me proud of what you'll become. The family of Mr. Travis DeMarco Armstrong is most appreciative of all the many kind and loving expressions of sympathy that have been shown to them during this time of sorrow. They ask for your continued prayers in the days to come. May each of you continue in the blessings of the Lord. The following floor arrangements and cards of sympathy have been sent to the family. With deepest sympathy, Kelvin, Kelby, and Siobhan Coulson. With deepest sympathy, Mr. Bobby and Dorothy Jones. With deepest sympathy, Miko and Shamika Collier. With deepest sympathy, Victor and Rosalind Mumford and family. Always in our hearts, Shabria, Tanaja, Tania, Collier. With deepest sympathy, the Mullane family. With deepest sympathy, Chot and C.O. With deepest sympathy, the Coney and the Edwards families. With thoughts of sympathy, the Davis family. The beautiful spray that adorns the casket is given in love and memory of a caring and devoted companion, father, grandfather, brother, uncle, cousin, and friend, love the family. In love and memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and President, and the J.W. Weems Funeral Home staff, would like to present to this family an African American heirloom Bible in the hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. For scripture tells us that weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. The J.W. Weems Funeral Home family would also like to present to this family a pictorial tribute of your loved one's life. It is our hope that you will forever remember the many cherished memories you shared together as a family. And finally, the J.W. Weems Funeral Home family would like to present to this family a memorial keepsake blanket. It is our prayer that you wrap yourself in the love and warmth that this blanket has to hold. It is our prayer that you're blessed now and always.